Hi everyone!
Hello!
As you can tell, we have Ben today, and probably you guys didn't know this, and we are going to give you some background information. So as you know, we did this K-pop Academy thing, and everybody was kind of from different parts of the UK. So when you guys will see our special reunion video, that means that people put in a lot of effort to, you know, meet again. And this is basically our Oxford crew, because we are in Oxford, but Ksenia is in London. And funny thing is, I've been obsessed with Super Junior recently. And did you know, by the way, that we are in Oxford and Super Junior did lecture at the Oxford Union?
Did they really?
Yes, they did. I just
That was awesome.
So I'm currently on a quest to figure that out. That probably they must have...
Well, Cy did though, didn't he? So I guess that makes sense. Cy did one at the Oxford Union.
Yeah,
as well.
Yeah. But like, I'm gonna quest to find their picture on the Oxford Union wall, because it has to be there. Anyway, we are going to watch an amazing boy band today in our random acts series.
I kept this one secret from Ildi. I don't know why. I just thought it'd be fun that way. Mm-hmm. I'm introducing her to a group that I think are very underrated, mm-hmm. and that have made some very good songs. People do know, they just don't know that they're by them. I'm going to be showing her Cross Gene today.
Cross Gene, okay. And do we have lyrics? No, that's fine. Yeah, I know, and you're not a lyrics person. Yeah, okay, well, I'm ready. Let's start in 1, 2, 3. Strong makeup, very strong makeup already.
That's tackier.
This feels Japanese for some reason.
One of the members is Japanese. And the company is Japanese. So this song translates as "play with me." Take that how you will.
Yeah, it definitely feels Japanese. What is this makeup?
Oh, oh my, I like them
God.
So much. Sangmin, the rapper.
This is a banger.
Oh yeah.
Oh wow. Oh.
Yeah, but look, he gets his comeuppance.
This is what happens when you're... This is definitely reminds me of Infinite.
It's Why do you think I like them?
It's kind of like a dance music kind of thing. Oh no! This is inappropriate!
Shinna, our leader. He's quite a famous actor.
Uh-huh.
He's in The Legend of the Blue Sea.
And back. This dance is very cool. Hey! I could do this part.
It's so good.
This mental health institute has very weird rules. And surprisingly colorful walls.
Oh, this is Casper, by the way. He's Chinese, he's a rapper.
So this is an international group,
yeah? Yeah, they had Chinese members, Korean members, and a Japanese member.
I think that really adds flavor to groups.
This is Seong, he's our main vocalist.
He has, with this makeup, he reminds me of Joker for some reason.
I think that's what they're going for. Everyone's a bit mad, so...
Mad for you, or mad...
It's just mad. I mean, like, Shin's got, like... he's like L from Death Note.
His phrase and everything. Are they trying to hypnotize us?
Are they succeeding? Probably not. Now go into BAM.
This could be like a club hit in at any you know party that we go to, honestly.
A lot of people know this chorus, they just don't know the song. Takia.
Oh! Hey!
Of course she's in love with Tapia. Just kidding.
Who is that guy? Is he the doctor or like director of the institute or whatever? This is a very weird institute, by the way. There's only one, you know, member of the staff.
One poor nurse trying to keep all of CrossGene in check.
And everybody else is like, there are no more people. Okay, first reaction. Even like in the visuals, mm-hmm. I think I almost felt like there is some sort of diversity, but it's hard to put my finger on it. And when you mentioned like, okay, then the label is Japanese and there are Japanese and Chinese members. Generally, I think that really adds to the color of a band. Mm-hmm. So I, for example, recently tried to look into GOT7, which wasn't a band that I, you know, necessarily followed. And when it comes to their interactions and just, and I don't know, just their stage presence and obviously from a business perspective, it makes a lot of sense to kind of build. Get those markets. But I think even just like looking at the visuals, meaning like the members and how they are using their old beautiful facial structure to kind of, you know, create these characters in different music videos. I think, again, it's just a given that you would have people with different facial features, and then you have the chance to experiment with makeup, for example, in here. And and again, it's crazy when you see these videos, and these guys can pull it off. Like I would look like a clown.
Same.
You get what I mean? Yeah. It's very special. So
they looked a bit silly in this video, though. Just so much eye makeup.
But wasn't that the point?
I guess. Yeah.
Wasn't that the point? And was this an early video? Was this like a mid?
It's kind of early mid, I guess. I think this would be like, was it like 2013, 2014 maybe? They started in 2012, so.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's pretty early. Then they've been around. Didn't they come to the UK recently?
They probably did. I'm not sure.
I kind of remember seeing it as like.
Oh, I'm not sure. I don't know. I think I would have heard about it. I don't know.
It's interesting.
I hope they do again though, because I'll go see them.
So for you, CrossGene is it like one of your favorite bands? Or
I don't know. They're just kind of like one of these bands that I think are way smaller than they should be. Like they're kind of like 2-4K for me and KNK, where I think they're really good and they're great. They have some fantastic songs. They're not like, I don't look up to them like, oh, they're my favorite band ever. I watch all of their things every day. They're not like FX or Infinite for me, but they're still like up there. They're groups that I just think, oh, you make loads of songs I like. That's cool.
Interesting. That's interesting when you have those bands that you kind of, you know, just, it's almost like we have a range of K-pop artists that we follow or we like.
And well, then I like there are a some, lot, as you know.
There
so.
Are, yeah, there are some people at the top whom like we watch all the V-Live or like we just follow instantly or we know everything about them. There is the mid-range crowd, like we kind of, who we identify with or we follow them or interesting or, yeah, and then there are people who just like spark our interest and like especially from the rookie groups. I think since I'm still very, you know, young compared to a lot of K-pop fans in a sense that I'm new to the community, fairly new, I'm trying to build my range. I'm trying to build a catalogue to kind of compare things to.
I think that's why I found so many of these smaller groups, is because I've been around a while.
Mm-hmm. You've been around a while. It's like, what is this?
I'm an old man.
You're an old man. You've been around. Out and about.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm
like an old boot. You can't get rid of me.
No. We don't want to get rid of you, that's the thing. And when it comes, how much do you think it matters if the agency, it's either there is a Japanese presence and there's a Korean presence, or it's purely Japanese. Does that affect the band's musical style or direction that they are taking?
I think it obviously will, but I think that's difficult to. It's difficult to kind of quantify where you can tell that because it's a Japanese label, it's going to have a different style. But then you've got other like you've got Korean labels that make very J-poppy type stuff, and you think, what's this? But it doesn't, I don't think it's really the label so much. It depends on who they hire for, like, production or writing or something like that. Or in fact, what their members are good at as well, which is probably why cross genes sound quite Japanese style. They've got that kind of, because Takuya's Japanese, he's got that kind of typical Japanese vocal timbre, that kind of thing. You know they're going to do some of that. But they've also come in with a little bit of hip-hop style, I guess, on top of it.
But it's a very soft hip-hop style.
Very soft.
Like, recently, I've been showing some mixtape things, BTS mixtape things, to Ksenia, and she didn't even know what a mixtape is, in a sense, like, in a hip-hop world. So it was a very interesting experience for her. And what she found, since she never really listened to hip-hop, not even Western hip-hop, no hip-hop edit whatsoever, so she found the mixtapes incredibly aggressive, like the rapping-wise, because she's used to different snippets in a K-pop song, so she's not used to a full performance, a full hip-hop performance, so like, it was, I definitely agree that when there are rap parts in pop music, they are just softer, because the overall presence, it would stand out way too much if it would be like, obviously it has to be very rhythmic, but it just it is a different kind of thing when if it's within the song. But the other thing that I was really struck by, that this sounds to me, it sounds like a Europop song.
That I think that's why I like it, because it's I kind of love Europop. I guess it's that chorus though, isn't it? Like, the rest of the song
Honestly, like, this could have been like a...
This could have been like a 90s hit.
90s hit, or like when you know, guys know that I'm Hungarian, like when Hungary, like Czech Republic and Poland or whatever, did an application for like, to organize European championships, like a football championships, and like, we have an official song, and this is how it sounds like. Like, do you get what I mean?
It sounds
so Europop, and like, that's why probably for our ears, it's very catchy. And again, it's just a wonderful thing about, you know, the universal aspect of music, that like something can be very popular or very, you know, liked in a completely different part of the world. So like, I would say these were the three things that really, you know, struck me: the international group aspect, the Europop sound, and just kind of like this visual diversity that they are able to, you know, able to express within this music video, even though it wasn't that crazy concept, in a sense, like, it wasn't an unusual concept. You could identify the ideas right away. Okay, so they're in a mental, you know, health institute or whatever. There is like a girl there, and then they are playing ping pong and whatever.
Shin is literally L from Death Note.
So yeah, I think that would be my general impression. Are we going to watch some more Christine, or are we going to?
Of course, more Christine. Okay.
Well, thank you guys for joining us, and give us some sort of, you know, if there are bands that you think that people are just sleeping on, and then we don't know about it enough, we will try our best to find the best person to introduce it to our lovely audience.
We know we have some K&K fans. We should probably get on that.
Yeah, K&K. Working on it, guys. Thank you for now, and see you guys very, very soon. Bye.